What's up guys, Kamil here from Addictive Frames. In this video I'm going to show you how to create this graphic animation in DaVinci Resolve. So let's jump into it. Okay, here we are straight in Fusion. Let's grab background with alpha 0 as normal. I type in V to hide this window and I need one window here. Selecting this background, I'm going to grab another one. I'm gonna name it VG White, connected to this background with alpha 0, and I want this background to be white as I name it. And selecting this background, I'm going to grab polygon and I want to go to this corner and make first point here, go somewhere around here, and holding shift I want to drop another point here, and I want to uncheck show view controls, check border styles, uncheck solid, and border width go like that. That's gonna be about 003 as it was. Cool. I'm gonna name it polygon, whoops, f2 not f1. Okay, polygon vertical. Now I'm going to select this background, and before I want to make this node bigger, because always when I come back to the composition straight away, when I see big node, it means for me that I animated these nodes. Okay, let's select this background, copy this, paste in here, connect it here. Okay, we need another polygon and I'm gonna name it polygon horizontal, and I'm gonna make it bigger as well. I'm gonna start from the same corner, so that will be here, and I wanna drop another point here. Should be a little bit along the line, and we're gonna do the same things as we did in first line. Border width 003, and there we go. Okay, and now go to this polygon first, show view controls, and I'm gonna see this bar, and I'm gonna select insert and modify, and I want to select this point, go here and publish this point. And same I want to do with this, so here select this point and publish this point. Now we're gonna create arrows, so I'm gonna grab another background and I want to type in S star. Let's create two windows and the star will be on the left, and we need 3 points, and that's gonna be 90 degrees of angle. Let's put expression into height and connect it to width. We can manipulate all the triangle, and that's gonna be, I'm gonna name this star S star vertical. Selecting this S star, I'm going to type S render. I'm going to type into this background, this merge will be merge vertical. I'm going to connect this star to this point. The point is selected already, so we need to go to merge vertical, go to the center, right mouse button, and hit expression, and let's holding control, then we have a polygon vertical here and merge vertical is here. Let's grab this expression and go there and link this expression, link merge vertical to this published point of polygon. Nothing happening here because this node tree is not connected to the main node tree, and something's wrong. So I've done the same process, and just this merge needs to be connected to the same pipeline as these polygon points are. So I think you can find out how to do that. So focus on the right side. So let's close this left window. Select this left polygon, which is polygon vertical. When you move it, this triangle go along. So we want this to be somewhere here, and let's make this arrow a bit smaller to look nice, about that. And we're gonna do the same with the bottom line. So I just copy this star, paste it here, connect to this pipeline, and I'm gonna name this merge horizontal. I'm going to connect this merge, so I hit expression on center of merge horizontal and connect it to polygon horizontal to the publish point. And we've got the same situation, we need to change only angle of this star, so that will be 0, correct. And it works as well. Okay, cool. There we go, we have lines and triangle connected to lines. So for now we don't need guides, so I hit Ctrl G, and next step is creating growth line. So I grabbed background, that's gonna be white. No, actually that's gonna be green, sorry. That's gonna be green, this one, connected to the main node tree. And I want this merge, name it merge under, because I'm going to select operator under. And you will see in a minute why. I'm gonna select this background and I'll name it BG green. Selecting this BG green, I'm going to grab polygon. And from this point, we're gonna start creating our graph, going like that. Let's say this kind of line. Select this insert and modify. Select all points and make it smooth. And unthink show view controls to see what we're doing. I change the border style, uncheck solid, and border width will be bigger like that. Okay, there we go. We've got nice line. And we're going to animate this from frame zero, the length will be zero. Okay, and let's go to frame. Let's extend our composition. Actually, it's too small, so let's make it bigger. Go back to Fusion. On frame zero, the length will be zero. And let's go to frame 120 and make length like that to the full. And now let's remove polygon and publish. And now I'm going to grab text. I'm going to connect this text to the main node tree and hit here shift and four. That will be dollar, and this dollar will be green as well, like that. I'm going to shading. I'm gonna go to another tab, enabled, and change appearance, and I want this to be line. Okay, I'm going to do it, make it rounder like that, and extend not vertical but horizontal, something like that. Change position and just adjust it to be perfect. Okay, if you want to be perfect, you can do it. I always want to be perfect. And now change it to the black. Okay, and now with this text, selecting this text, grab transform, and I want to change this transform. That will be transform path. Okay, and now we're going to center of this transform. We're going to select path, right mouse button on center path. Go to modifiers and you got displacement here, and I want to uncheck this diamond, and I'm going to connect to, and this is polygon polyline one value. Okay, and now we're going to frame zero, and with this transform we're going back to path, displacement, hit diamond here, go to frame, that was frame 120, correct. Go to transform and I make it bigger on the way I go. And this polygon, I want to make it bigger as well. Okay, and we're coming back to the transform. We on frame 120, we're going to modifiers on path, and on frame 120, we're going with displacement to the full. Okay, and now as you can see, this dollar, when you play, go along the line. I just want to smooth it out. So we need to select polygon, and I rename this polygon path, and I'm going to select polygon path and transform path, and I'm going to spline editor, select all the points. So we've got green color because they are aligned. I'm going to select these two points, hit F, T, and I'm going to 85. Close spline editor. Now it's smooth and nice. Now I want to do these green lines here. So what I want to do, I want to grab this polygon path. No, actually polygon path and BG background, BG green, copy that, paste it a bit further to have a distance to see that is something else what we do. So in this polygon, I'm going to remove publish. I'm going to deselect length. I don't want anything to be animated, and I'm going to make it solid. And I'm going to polygon path, and I will change it to polygon filling. and I want to see this bar on the top, but I can't see, I don't know why. Oh, I need to check show view controls, okay. And now we can see the bar here. And now guys, let's click append. Let's go up there and hit around this arrow, okay. And close this polygon here. And we need to adjust everything. So I wanna name this merge under filling. I'm going to this polygon, selecting this point. I hold control and adjust the lines, okay? This point here. Okay, and this point here. Something like that. And with this merge under filling, I want to go with blend a little bit down, adjust a little bit. I want to select this polygon filling and go to rectangle, and this rectangle I want to be minimum, okay? And now as you can see, this rectangle will fill nicely the space where we want to animate this line. And I want to create that will go at the same, animate at the same time where the graph will grow. This rectangle, I want to make it bigger because this will be animated. I'm going to rename it rectangle filling, and I want to make it a soft edge like that. Maybe a bit more. And selecting this rectangle, I'm going to hit Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and I want to show view controls, and I want to go like this. And soft edge will be even bigger here. Okay, so now when you move this rectangle, in my opinion, it looks quite nice. Okay, that will finish around here. Okay, maybe we put up this rectangle a little bit like that. And let's go to merge under. Let's see how it goes when we put the blend up. No, that was good. Let's put it in 0.8. Okay, something telling me that needs to be 0.8. And now we're going to grab transparent background, connect it to here, and selecting this background, hit shift space, and type in grid, and we need this grid. And I want to, this is my version of grid, so you can copy these parameters. I just want to make till this animate and major line spacing like that. Maybe zoom in a little bit like that. Okay. And now let's grab this rectangle and connect it to the grid. Okay. And go to the merge of the grid and put blend a little bit down. Okay. And maybe change the zoom of the grid. It looks nicer where is more squares. And I want to adjust this polygon because I can see it goes beyond the line. I want to go follow, so I want this number to disappear. I mean, this dollar symbol to disappear. So I want to select this merge below the text and hit Ctrl P, and it will disappear. Okay. And I can adjust this polygon like that. Let's go like that and go with this point, hold control and adjust it nicely. Looks good. Now we need to go to the polygon path. And when we are in frame 120, we need to go to this rectangle filling. This rectangle filling, we need to make it smaller because it's not gonna be animated. Okay, so this rectangle filling on 120, the position of this rectangle will be here. So let's animate center of this rectangle and go to frame 0 and move back this rectangle here, where you don't see any green point. And now, selecting this rectangle filling, I'm going to go to polygon path, selecting this as well. So both of these nodes are selected. Go to spline editor And with polygon path, just thick ones, click here. And what is left is rectangle filling. So you can select rectangle filling and adjust to the, aligned it with the spline, with the lines of, with the spline, actually, this is spline, correct name for this line. So correct, align this with the spline of polygon. Okay. So that was hit F. And on T, I remember that was about 85. Yeah, as you can see, now is perfectly aligned. Great. Let's close spline editor. And now guys, let's animate the rest of the composition. And I want to do the text appeared again. So that's how it looks like with all animation. And I want to, at the beginning of the animation, I want these arrows, animate these arrows. So on frame 30, go to polygon vertical and animate published point, and for polygon horizontal, same. And now go to frame 0, and again we need to deselect text, so control P on merge, and go back to the polygons, and we need to guys actually uncheck view controls. We now here on polygon vertical and hold, I mean, go to center Y of the polygon published point. Okay, like that. And it needs to be like here. Same as polygon horizontal, go with point X center and move it to here. And what else I want to do, I want to appear everything in 10 frames. So let's say, let's go to frames number 10, go to this merge. Actually, I want to select these two merge. These two merges are below polygon horizontal, and these are selected already. And we need to go to select this merge of the dural symbol, and this merges as well. And I'm going to click right mouse button and make it show type pictures. Each of this merge needs to be selected at blend. Now we go to frame number 0, and each merge needs to go blend down. And now let's show text and go to frame 0. Guys, let's hit play and see how it goes. And it looks quite nice. And to see effect of that, because it doesn't look good on transparent background, go with alpha 1, and now it looks better, okay? But I can see what is wrong here is polygon path is under the black background, okay? As you can see, merge here. So what we can do is, I'm gonna select this background, put it down here, grab another transparent background, connect it here, move this black background here, and connect it like that, and connect it back to media out. And there we go, we're back in the game. Maybe change the appearance, I mean the second tab of the color of the second tab in dollar symbol. It could be, I think that would look better if it's gray or something else, I don't know, maybe yellow, something contrast to. So let's make it white, and this dollar symbol will be red. Okay. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching. If you don't like waiting until your video will be rendered, I found a solution for that, which you can find in this video here. So see you there.